Mr. Sewell, it's so late. Is everything all right?
No, I just ran into Mel down there. She tried to drag me into her room. I don't want to think what could have happened if she got me in there. She probably wanted to dissect me.
She wouldn't do that.
Hey, you never know with a girl like that. She might! Huh? What's going on, kid? You look like you're having fun. What's up?
Nothing. I'm just happy that I can talk to you like this, that's all.
Oh.
Yep.
But, yeah, you know.
Yes?
Yeah, I guess we never talked like this before, huh?
No, we didn't.
Well, cut me some slack, all right? We were going through a lot. I was going through a lot. I'm still...
It's okay. I know that deep down, you're a really nice guy.
Nice, huh? Well, that's great. But being nice ain't enough. Being nice isn't gonna save people I care about. That's why I gotta...
Mr. Sewell?
Hey, what am I doing? Something's wrong with me, telling you all this crap. Maybe because it's nighttime. I better get back to my room.
Mr. Sewell?
What is it? Why so serious?
Do you think that we could do this again? You know, just talk about stuff that isn't work?
Sure, when I feel like it.
Thank you. I'll look forward to it.
Get back to bed, kid.
Okay. Good night, Mr. Sewell.
Yeah. I'm not going to that kid's room. Come on. After all, it's bedtime for kids.
Yes, yes. Yes, it is. Nighttime is the time for adults. So, now that that's out of the way, why don't you come to my room? I'm sure we have all sorts of things to... talk about.
Whoa! What the hell? Well, yeah, all right. But you and I are gonna have words. I got some stuff to say to you.
So, here's my room. And this is the tea I poured for you. Go on, drink it.
Drink it all!
You didn't, you know, put something in here, did you? Like, sleeping pills?
Well, I never! Do you really think that I would resort to such an obvious trap? I'm hurt! The only thing in this tea is an herb that will warm you up. When you drink it, you will become so hot that you will have no choice but to take your clothes off.
That's not any better! What's your problem? Don't you think about anything besides dissection?
Well, of course I do. I also think about world peace and how I can bring happiness to mankind. I also think about what I'll have for breakfast. You know, important things.
So breakfast is about as important as world peace, huh?
Isn't it? Dissection can wait. Today I will merely observe... I mean, let's talk.
Talk?
Yes, yes, talk. Converse. Communication! Playing catch with words. To be honest, just observing you is awfully entertaining. This conversation is but the first step. Soon, all your secrets will be revealed to me as I tease them out of you, one by one. So, here are some questions. How can you release so much magic? Do you recall being altered in any way? What's your favorite food? What color pants are you wearing?
Hey, look, you're just bombarding me with questions. This ain't a conversation.
It's not? Well, this is how I normally converse with people. Is there something wrong with it?
Yeah, a lot.
Oh, it's so difficult to talk to common people. I can't fathom what you're thinking about. You...
can think, right?
Of course I can think!
I suppose rushing things isn't going to help me. As they say, patience is a virtue.
Look, we're in this together. I'd like to have at least some idea where you're coming from. Though I'm starting to wonder if that's even possible.
Well then, we must have sessions like this one more frequently. A special communication time, just for you and me.
Did it suddenly get colder in here? Maybe I'm imagining things. Alright, so we're off to Mount Ishtar. I think that's...
northwest of Tarim Wood. It's farther to the west than the ruins, so make sure you get it right.
Wow, Mel, you sure know a lot.
Yes, well, I don't wish to brag, but I know a great deal. A great deal. Far more than you can comprehend. So long as I am accompanying you, your journey will be much... much easier.
All right. Let's just get moving, shall we?
Oh, by the way, Crace, have you visited the Great Library in Floromoss?
Library? Why?
Well, I thought you might want to read up on Mount Ishtal.
I don't need to research a mountain.
What are you saying? Knowledge is power.
You don't think we can just, you know, wing it?
But... why? Sophie, can you convince him?
Oh, well, I leave everything up to Mr. Sewell.
See? If the kid says we don't gotta go, we don't gotta go. Come on, you two. Let's move.
Okay.
But... it's so fun.
Mel?
Okay, I get it. Fine!
Mr. Toast, Mr. Cream?
Not this again.
Please, just for a little while?
I give up. Do whatever you want.
Yay! Don't mind if I do! All right, tell me what happened. How did you end up here? Good?
Meow.
Thank you, Mr. Toast, Mr. Cream. Can you tell me some more stories the next time I see you?
Meow.
Done?
Yep, let's go.
Okay. Hey, kid.
Yes?
Do you really understand what they're saying?
Are you wondering what they told me?
No.
They went through a whole lot to get here. It's been a long journey.
A journey?
And a difficult one. But they were there for each other. That's how they made it here. Do you want to hear the story?
No. Not really.
Oh. Well, if you ever want to, just let me know.
Ha! No way.
Thank you.
Ah!